Retrontario's got something new. It's a hairspray breakthrough. New Mighty Mist hairspray. It's the latest news. It's micro diffusing. That's a mist that's so fine. It's even all over every time.
Mighty Ho, you can touch. Not too little, not too much. Too Mighty Mist hairspray.
It's micro diffused.
Get the mic.
Touch it.
Great bargain hunter, and I'll go anywhere by any means to find the right price. And this time I found the big one, the buyer's flea market, with hundreds of vendors and acres of free parking. But it's the prices that will knock you out. The buyer's flea market is open on Saturdays and Sundays from 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. That's why I took the helicopter. There's no time to lose. The buyer's flea market, 724 Caledonia Road, just south of Lawrence.
Sometimes you say some amazing things, Nikki.
Friday.
Yeah?
The fragile world of twin brothers.
Gino loves me.
Is threatened by a family secret.
Why did you lie?
Shut up! What do you think my life's about? You don't think it has something to do with you?
He's stupid. I'm slow.
Your brother has some temper.
Come here! I can't watch you every minute! I'm not God!
Tom Hulce.
You go to school, I work!
And Ray Liotta.
You have to believe in your strength, Nikki.
Dominic and Eugene, Friday at 8 on City. Driving and shooting along Bay Street. This is City TV everywhere.
Get ready and action.
This is the ship, Captain.
The Coneheads pay a visit to Planet Hollywood.
Cones on wheels.
Feel like a distant lost horizon.
Soundies, jukebox videos from the 40s.
Any number of people who went on to dramatic careers can be seen as generally extras in the Soundies.
You killed my parents.
You killed my parents. Stop.
Russian video piracy. And Whoopi and Ted, an item? This week on Movie Television.
Well, let me ask me that again. What are you asking me? I said no.
I'm Jeanne Beker. Wayne's World and the Blues Brothers movies have really proved that Saturday Night Live sketches could be taken from the small screen to the big screen. Well, now that we await a sequel to Wayne's World, producer Lorne Michaels and company have decided to really go out of this world. Recent visitors to Paramount's back lot may have confused the studio for the planet Remulac, but you can't blame them. 17 years after a Saturday Night Live sketch introduced them to the world, the Coneheads are going to the movies. Paramount is bankrolling the $30 million project, which features lots of familiar faces, and rushing it to screens for this summer.
This movie, no one really has figured that out yet. I don't know. I never even seen a script, and I'm supposed to have written it. So I
fire the writer first.
All I know is they put this cone on me, they send me out there, they wind me up. Fortunately, I have an excellent leading lady with me in this venture.
So you're sort of letting her carry it?
Jane, how are you, honey?
I'm carrying the picture for you, Dan.
Ah, see what I mean?
Just like that.
She's great. She's, of course, my old partner from Saturday Night Live. And remember, Jane, you ignorant slut.
No.
I felt terrible about doing that because I love and loved Jane back then as a co-worker, colleague, and friend. And we kind of just fell right back into the old Saturday night, you know, mentality.
Okay, right, let's do it. Get ready and action.
This is the ship, Captain. Secure your form flat fasteners. We'll initiate Mentavian surge as soon as we go past the only moon of this planet.
For British-born director Steve Barron, whose previous credits include Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, Remulac and Beldar weren't exactly household words, but he sees the international appeal of the Coneheads.
Like,
most people, I think, in Europe, you've got that image because you've seen it on the late night show somewhere, or when they brought the series over. And I remembered the image, but I couldn't have quoted any of the lines, and I didn't know that well. And I was sent the tape, and I was a bit skeptical about what the movie would be when I was sent the tape. But then the script followed, and it was a great idea. It was a really cleverly worked script that was its own, a movie in its own right, whether you knew the kind of knew about anything. It had a really underplayed story, cleverly woven. It's like, you know, it was the only story you could tell, which is the story of the illegal alien and the immigration authorities. So it was it fit perfectly. It felt new, original, and belonged. It didn't feel contrived.
Mike's in the show, of course. You see, he is one of these professional, consummate professionals. Walks in cold, doesn't know there's a camera here, and immediately just segues right into the public personality.
I did go to the bathroom when I saw the camera.
Ah, yeah.
That's, I'll just slip off. This has got to be Canadian business you're talking about, huh?
It is.
He's wearing a cone in this
one. No, he's our
INS. Token human.
Yeah.
Yes, I'm the earthly nemesis of the cone.
He is, and he's doing a fantastic job.
Be prepared to hiss.
Nah, it's worth it because we're in a vehicle here that's going to make people laugh, and I that's back to what I do for a living. So I'm happy about it personally.
Cones on wheels.
The buzz in Hollywood is that the new romantic comedy from Whoopi Goldberg and Ted Danson called Made in America could be one of the big hits this summer. And the couple's off-screen relationship also has Hollywood buzzing. But as Terry David Mulligan discovered, the couple isn't saying much.
Now, I gotta play goofy here, because I've been moving. I've been busy doing other things with my family. And have I missed something here? Are you two an item?
No.
Okay, I just wanted to know that, because I don't know these things.
Uh-huh.
Good deal.
Well, let me ask me that again. What are you asking me? I said no. What are you asking me?
I just asked.
All right.
What is that? What does that word mean? I don't know.
You mean we like each other a lot?
Yeah.
Yes?
Yes, we do.
Yes?
Yes, yes, I bought the sperm. I asked for the best they had. You know, black, smart, not too tall.
Hello there, can I help you?
Hi, I'm looking for Hal Jackson.
Well, look no further.
Wait a minute, what do you mean, white? He's like white wine?
It's Hal Jackson.
This is Hal Jackson from Jackson Motors.
You mean the schmuck on the television with all the animals?
And this is Larry.
How's your pal?
Are you a fan of this television show that he was just talking about?
I've not really ever seen Cheers.
You've never seen these guys? Just as they're leaving, they'll be around for an eternity, you know?
What's funny is she was friends with a lot of people in the cast.
Yes, I know all of them, but I'm not a big television person.
Okay.
So, you know, we'd be shooting and people would be screaming, "Hey, Sam." And finally one day I said, "What?
Who is this?
Why are they calling me Sam?" And he explained it, you know, and my mother said, "I can't believe you asked him that." But I knew him from other things. I knew him from something about Amelia and Cousins and Dad. That's the work that I knew. So, I mean, I'm thrilled to learn all about Cheers, you know, but I know him from other stuff.
Bodies, Rest, and Motion was a big hit at the Sundance Film Festival. It's a movie about two couples in their late 20s who are trying to bring some meaning to their lives. But these people are so wrapped up in themselves that they're oblivious to the world around them.
You know, I was thinking that maybe we could be roomies, you know. Roomies? Just until you figure out what's next.
I can't.
Why not?
Because if I don't go now, I'll just wind up staying with him. He just gets to me too much.
It would have been a very different movie had they been aware of politics or economy. I think that's what they're about. They are so sort of dissatisfied with their own lives that they're just looking for a way out. They can't possibly, you know, be bothered with worrying about anything outside of themselves.
You know what you want?
I want you.
For me, it's such a small amount of time, and so many other things are happening that are so much more important to them at that moment, which is also part of it. I mean, these things just blow up and take over their life. What am I going to do? I've got to move. I've got to be, you know, my life is where is it? You know, and I just
don't know, man. Maybe you just have really advanced friends. But my friends, my friends do not sit around and talk about politics and economics. They talk about, you know, who's sleeping with who and what are you gonna do tonight and gee, doesn't this suck? And
I'm lonely and bitter.
I'm lonely and bitter and angry. I have a lot of bitter friends. But they do it with a smile on their face.
Toronto is hosting its first ever Jewish film festival. With an international roster of films, it's hoped that the festival will focus on the diversity of the Jewish experience.
Hi, my name is Lovey. I'm from Brooklyn also. And ever since I've been to Israel, I just love it. I love this. It's a nice place. I wouldn't mind moving here.
The Jewish film festivals that I've been to around the world, the audience is very mixed. You know, the old advertisement in New York about you don't have to be Jewish to love Levi's Rye? Well, it's the same thing about the Jewish Film Festival. You don't have to be Jewish to love the Jewish Film Festival.
It's 350 degrees.
These films appeal to everybody. They're about human emotions. They're about stories that could happen to anyone. Some of the films deal with things that happen to be Jewish, but don't have to be Jewish.
Soundies, old-time film videos, and Russian video piracy. Next on Movie Television. I'm just a love machine, and I won't work for nobody but you.
Duracell. You can't talk the copper talk.
If your family loves the taste of ripe, juicy fruit, make a little magic with McCain Fruit Punch. McCain makes frozen punch from real concentrated fruit juice, so you can really taste the fruit. Great with grapes. Outstanding with orange. McCain Punch, frozen and now ready to drink. You can taste the quality because you can taste the fruit. She doesn't
worry, time's on her side. Continuous action, soft and dry, for time-release deodorant protection that lasts all day and all night. Soft and dry.
I'm one.
I'm definitely one.
I am two.
I used to be one, but now I'm three.
New Alberto Blush Shampoo and Conditioner in One has three unique levels of conditioning. One for light, two for regular, and three for extra. New Alberto Blush Shampoo and Conditioner in One.
What number are you?
Excuse me, I'm a doctor.
Wednesday, City gets serious about medicine.
Clean, zipper, chippy.
You'll make a fine doctor, Steph. Keep up the good work.
There are more than 20 vital bodily fluids, and I'm proud to say that I have tasted them. Yeah.
You're going to have to do the operation, son.
Start slicing.
Harry Dean Stanton, Dabney Coleman, Michael McKean, Sean Young, and Kramer.
Who?
He's big, lady. What are you, an extra? Young Doctors in Love, a premiere Wednesday.
Serve the public trust. Protect the innocent. Uphold the law. Drop the gun. You are under arrest. You have the right to remain silent. You have the right to an attorney. Anything you say may be used against you. Book him. He's a cop killer.
Thank you for not smoking.
They dubbed it From Russia with Larceny, a joint sting operation by the Toronto Police, RCMP, and the Film Security Office have busted a Russian piracy ring, seizing a record 600 rental tapes and video masters.
Well, we received a complaint at the beginning of March regarding a video piracy investigation regarding copyright infringed videos. That came from Max Gordon of the Film Security Office here in Toronto. As a result of that complaint, we entered in an investigation these videos were infringing copies and they were dubbed in Russian, which is an offense under the Copyright Act.
You killed my parents.
Ты убил моих родителей. Что?
What are you talking about?
О чем ты?
Russia has been a bit of a thorn in her side in terms of copyright violations. There's a large black market of Hollywood movies in Russia. As a result of that, these infringing copies that had been knockoffs in Russia had been imported into Canada. Some of them, in fact, had been sourced from Laserdiscs, in that as soon as you put the copy on, you could see the Laserdisc logo, and it was very easy to determine that that had been the original source. Of course, none of our American companies, such as Paramount, Columbia, Fox, etc., they all use very professional labels, both face and spine labels, and the quality of these video cassettes left a lot to be desired in terms of not only video quality, but also audio quality. The bottom line was the actual dubbing was a fairly crude method of dubbing.
Morning.
Доброе утро.
Доктор
Лектор, меня зовут Клариса Старлинг.
Well, the biggest challenge was, first of all, having the language interpreted. And we then went to Metro Toronto Police, who have several members that speak fluent Russian. And we had a member come over and work with us for approximately a week. And he was able to infiltrate exactly where the videos were coming from. And at that point, we had enough grounds to obtain two search warrants and execute two search warrants on both the store and the residence. And without someone with that ability to speak Russian, it would have made the case extremely difficult.
How about Rumble?
Здравствуйте, Олег.
What about you?
Where's Lips Manless?
Yeah, Губастый Менлис.
The motion picture industry on a worldwide basis loses $1.5 billion annually. And you know, that is a serious matter. And the poor old consumer ultimately pays for this type of a problem.
I mean, just imagine you're playing a record and you have a 3-minute record. And instead of it being audio only, you have an early video with it. Only at that time it was film. It was 16 millimeter film, which was projected in a machine.
Clink, clink, the glasses clink, making tinkly music till the dawn is breaking.
It's started jumping, really jumping. Come and catch it, your ass.
I believe this yard is jumping.
There were prototypes of this visual jukebox as early as 1938, but it was 1940 when maybe 6, 7, 8 companies started production on either films or the screening devices. And it just happened to be that Soundies were the films that made it after this transition period, and Panoram machines were the projection units of choice.
What is history's greatest date since the Bill of Rights?
The greatest date in history was the one I had last night.
The greatest date in history was the one she had last night.
I think one of the most interesting aspects of Soundies is that they share for us a different level of reality in terms of musical performance in the 1940s. Most people could not afford to go to the Cotton Club, they couldn't afford to go to the Coconut Grove, they couldn't afford to go to the Rainbow Room in New York City. What were the entertainments that these middle-class Americans saw night in and night out? And Soundies reflects a fascinating look back to that era.
Please feed the kitty. Oh, mister, have pity on her.
Meow. You try to do it in the maximum, averaging out at 3 takes or no more. And that's liberal. Actually, and you have to allow that for what we call rubber in not matching against the playback, and that would sometimes eat up a little film.
Well, Soundies used cheesecake to an amazing degree. Scantily clad women were found in many, many, maybe even most Soundies.
A lot of the kick for me is trying to find the parts and pieces to put the panoramas and the projectors back together again
In the 1950s, they were basically taken apart and made into peep shows, and a lot of the sound pieces of the projectors were pulled off, and I collect some as peep shows and sell them off as that with the 1950 girly movies. And then the one on the right over here is one that's been refinished, that's going to be refurbished all the way back to the original condition as a panoram. Well, basically what happens when you put a dime in, there's color wheels on the inside, and the marquee that's lit up with the moving strip will shut off, and a 16 millimeter sound film will start up.
You're like a distant lost horizon, my love. You're unattainable to me.
Any number of people who went on to dramatic careers can be seen as generally extras in the soundies. There was a group in New York which stood in and mouthed the words that were recorded previously to vocal choruses. And one of the gentlemen who turns up in many of these choruses is Ricardo Montalban. In a soundie featuring Rita Rio and her orchestra in 1941, she leads the band through the first chorus, and up comes the male band singer, Rita Rio's band being all female. It happens to be Alan Ladd. And this, of course, well before This Gun for Hire and all of his hard guy roles.
I look at you and a trumpet plays so sweet. I look at you and a drum begins to beat.
You had to hire an inexpensive studio and a minimal crew and work very, very economically. You got $1,500 for 3 minutes. Now, that was, of course, in the early 40s, so you better multiply that by 10. That's the same as $15,000 today.
In many ways, it's fair to say the Soundies were the first MTV.
I've knocked down the fences to meet you.
Coming of age, a look at love in the golden years.
Even at our age, we can fall in love and have a meaningful romance.
Next on Movie Television.
It's kind of like your own private lava lamp, you know what I mean? So you can be right inside it all the time. And it's really interesting.
Wake up to sunshine, it's a brand new day. Wake up to breakfast, the A&W way. Eggs are cooking just the way you like. Bacon sizzling, coffee brewed just right. Time is short, you're in demand. Got a bacon and egg in your hand. Wake up to sunshine, it's a brand new day. Wake up to breakfast, the A&W way.
Wake up to a real breakfast at A&W.
Take a look. This is new. Feels good, too.
This is how it's meant to be.
A friendly smile, a winning style, yeah. The train could change how you look at travel.
This is the way. Take a look at the train today.
Funny.
Sunday, they've got a wild weekend ahead, but there's a small problem with the host.
Larry Lomax is dead.
Hi, Tawny. I'm horny.
Oh, hi.
Get off your asses.
He's right. Weekend at Bernie's 8 Sunday on City.
Excuse me. I'm a doctor.
Wednesday, City gets serious about medicine.
You'll
make a fine doctor, Stephanie. Keep up the good work.
Young Doctors in Love. Great fun in a City premiere Wednesday.
The aging process is something that we're all concerned about. We are all growing older, but one thing to be remembered is that our need for love and passion doesn't dissipate as the years go by. That's the subject of a new romantic TV movie which recently wrapped shooting in Toronto. It's called Coming of Age, and it stars Jan Rubisch and Marion Gilsonen.
It would be nice.
I don't care.
You could charge more rent.
Thomas.
I could pick one up. They are on sale.
Thomas, we are not putting a jacuzzi down there, and that's final.
Strangely enough, I'm paying a Czech. A Czech farmer who came to Canada some years ago, and I am widowed, and the main lady is, what do you call it? She loses her husband, so she's a widow. And they meet, and they eventually fall in love. So it's sort of a story, upbeat story for the old folks, that even at our age, we can fall in love and have a meaningful romance.
I've knocked down the fences to meet you.
I think it's a really warm film, and it does have a great learning value, but without hammering it over the head, you know. The learning part of it is subtle, because you're actually watching people living through, for Jane, a fairly difficult time, and for her daughter, Heather, a difficult time. And you're seeing people coping with things, and that's, you know, just watching that as a learning experience.
I actually thought that characters like Jane McKenzie have been kind of invisible characters in our culture, in our society. So I'm interested in looking at characters like that and finding out what they're about.
Frame.
Oh, we're Jewish. Well, I am. She converted when she...
She means me. When Arthur talks about me, he means...
That's right.
When the writers, when they realized they got me for the role, one of my tools of I wanted to say seducing. No, not seducing. It's sort of charm myself into her favors was that I'm actually singing. And I'm going to sing for her. Perche voda te trce zvalecky mahajil njehal sima njehal staroda mi fra. It's a Czech old love song.
Falling in love is such a great experience. I mean, it shouldn't be limited just to the young people, and indeed it isn't.
No matter what age the audience, I'd like them to come away with some sense of affirmation of themselves and their own experiences of living in the everyday life that they live.
And now let's take a look at some of the stories we're working on for you for Movie Television. Stallone is the Demolition Man.
This is basically what I like, this is what I feel, this is what I believe, this is what I always dreamed about doing as a kid, so I'm just doing what comes naturally.
Sorry, Mr. Lee. No smoking? Smoke.
And smoking in the movies lights up a controversy.
I am against politicization of anything artistic.
That's it for this week's show. We'll see you next time. I'm Jeanne Beker.
Whole group of fun guys head down to Asia's number one holiday choice in Club Vietnam. I thought it was Thailand. Well, no time to talk about it now. Grab the tanning oil, everyone. Missing in Action's next on Great Movies.
Everybody be careful. We don't know what could come flying up here. Just be ready to move.
Going very quietly.
Lowest prices ever.
That's right. Come into the Brick. On Sunday and Monday only, check inside our full-color catalog and get this beautiful, casual, contemporary sofa. Save over $200. Our lowest price ever, just $388. This McLaren full-size, heavy-duty washer, our lowest price ever, only $376. And your satisfaction with the Brick is always guaranteed, or your money back. Everything's on sale, plus everything in our full-color catalog at the lowest prices ever. Hurry. Sunday and Monday only at the Brick.
Daddy Rock, I'm hungry.
Again?
I am a moose.
Meanwhile, Boris and Natasha plan the demise of our hungry heroes.
Hey, boys, try amazing Boris Burger.
Burgers are boring.
Are not.
Are so. Are not.
Are so.
Fortunately, keen debate skills and good taste prevail.
Come on, Bullwinkle, we're going to Taco Bell.
Oh, boy.
Disaster is averted as Rocky and Bullwinkle run for the border for something really amazing. That one and only Taco Bell taste.
Sure beats cartoon food.
17, call.
News 17, news base.
Bill, make your way 1040, please. You'll be going with Judy.
What's up?
I'm going to Mount Sinai for a press conference at 1 o'clock.
What's your prediction for this year? We're going to have more homicides or less?
Is that the message that Bay Street wants to hear?
Okay, Lily, take it back to the top of the clip, 3243.
Quickest route back, Bill. We got less than an hour till airtime.
Today, the band stopped by the Mutch Environment.
This will be a year to remember, believe me.
Sometimes you say some amazing things, Nikki.
Friday.
Yeah?
The fragile world of twin brothers.
Gina loves me.
Is threatened by a family secret.
Why did you lie?
Shut up! What do you think my life's about? You don't think it has something to do with you?
I ain't stupid. I'm slow.
Your brother has some temper.
Come here! I can't watch you every minute! I'm not God!
Tom Hulce.
You go to school, I work!
And Ray Liotta.
You have to believe in your strength, Nikki.
Dominic and Eugene, Friday at 8 on City.
Snappy little tune, heading east on Adelaide, the city TV everywhere.